discussions on all 40 demands for grants for which the House had sitting for 6 days. The members gave their views and suggestions, and the minister tried their best to answer the queries and points raised by the opposition and ruling party members during the question hour and discussions on the demands. Most members are participated in 0 hour every day to raise the issue of the local importance and to seek the government response. I will suggest that written answers be sent to the members who raise the matter during 0 hours. I must say that sitting took place in the congenial and pleasant atmosphere. However, I would like to remind that required under Section 5 and 6 of the Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Act 2005, Honorable Finance Minister has to be table the state of fiscal policy to the state legislature while presenting the budget. Through the budget was presented, the statutory statement of the fiscal policy was not laid on the table of the legislature. Moreover, the Finance Minister Sahab had tabled the copies of the CAG reports on state finances and finance accounts and appropriation accounts for the year 2017-18 this morning, even as the discussion commenced on the appropriation bill. The members hardly got any time to get through these reports on the state finances and accounts and raise any issue and concern mentioned to the CAG report. So far, as the demands for the various departments are concerned, the minister have given elaborate reply to the points raised by the members, but I may point out that we had raised various important issues and wanted the minister to respond. We could not get satisfactory response on some of the issues. Hence, I would like to seek the response of the Chief Minister Sahab and the Finance Minister on some of this issue raised by MIM. Concerned over NRC and proposed detention centers, Speaker Sir, I would also like the CM Sahab to enlighten us on the issue of NRC, the Union Home Minister, through the Registrar General Citizen Registration India is understood to have issued direction for the taking up the field work for house-to-house enumeration throughout the country except Assam for the collection of the information relating to all persons who are usually residing within the jurisdiction of the local registrar between 1st April 2020 to 30th September 2020. The follow the Union Government decision to prepare the update the population register of the pursuance of the sub-rule of the Rule 3 of the Citizenship Registration of the Citizens of the Issue of the National Identity Cards, Rules 2033. It is also stated that Union Home Minister issued direction to the state government to open detention centers for the lodging those identify as illegal immigrants. I would like to know whether such instructions have been received. The minorities and the migrants from the other states residing in the state seems to be worried about these twin directions of the Union Government. We are measures been taken by the state government to instill the confidence amongst all the lawful citizens of the state that they have nothing to fear from the so-called updating of the NRC through house-to-house enumeration after next year. I take opportunity to bring the other key issues for the CM's response now. I request the Chief Minister Sahab and Janab Speaker Sahab to review the House Committee appointed by the first Telangana Assembly to inquire the WAF lands inequalities in cooperative housing societies and illegal sale and occupation of government lands. I request the government to nominate the members, revenue and legal on the WAF tribunal. I also urge government to take steps for the reconstitution of work board as there are vacancy of members from assembly, council, parliament and state bar council. I request the government to raise the income ceiling of rupees 5 lakh, age limit to 35 years for the minority students as par with SC and STs for the overseas scholarship, besides doubling the number to beneficiaries to 1,000 every year. I urge the government to expeditiously clear the Shadi Mubarak and Kalyana Lakshmi applications without delay. The bankable schemes for the minorities are not implemented for the last 3 years. Over 1.5 lakh applications are pending from 2016. I request that the poorest application should be disbursed rupees 50,000 subsidy to micro schemes and allocation should be increased to 160 crores. I also request the government to to entrust the training and skill development of the minority youth through the Minority Welfare Department to the NAC and the CETWIN. I request the government to start district-wise study centers for the minority youth for the recruitment test and common internet test, and upgrade the minority study circle at the Hyderabad into a residential coaching centers. 2.5 years ago, Telangana legislature adopted the Telangana BC, ST and ST Bill 2017 for raising the quota for backward Muslims to 12% and SCs to 10%. However, the bill is stuck up with the union government. I would like the CM Sahab to spell out the steps for sorting out the issue with the union government. I urge the government to take steps for implementation of Urdu as second official language and to nominate a Urdu scholar to the State Official Language Commission. I would like request the government to speed up construction of 2-bedroom houses in GHMC area and announce timeline for the allotment of these houses. I request the government to direct the GHMC to expedite the SRDP works on road widening, flyovers, skyways, footover bridges, parking lots, Charminar pedestrianizations, new bridges for the hawkers between Nayapul and Salarjung Bridge, model markets and nala widening in the old city. I urge the Hyderabad Metro Rail announce the timeline for the taking the completing the works of old city stretch of Metro Rail from Imli Bund to Falaknuma. I would like to demand the government to provide special assistance of rupees 500 crore to the Quli Qutub Shah Urban Development Authority from the CM Special Development Fund. I request the government to initiate works on Godavari Water Supply Phase 2 and Krishna Water Supply Phase 4 and construction of the reservoirs of Shamirpet and Chotupal to meet the future water needs of Hyderabad metropolitan water area. I would also request the government to direct Southern DISCOM to lay underground the cables and set up more substations and transformers in GHMC area, particularly in the old city. I urge the government to announce the date for the implementation of ASRA old age pension with reduced age limits of 57 years by calling for application from new eligible beneficiaries and processing this on priority of the Hyderabad city. Despite our repeated pleas to the Legislative Affairs Minister to give a specific assurance, he only told the House that government will take a call on the issue when we demanded that 2 mosques and temples in segregated premises be left untouched while construction the new segregated complex. I request the CM Sahab to direct the Roads and Building Department to retain the 2 mosques and temple at their existing location and allow prayers to be offered there while the construction of the new segregated is taken up. Speaker sir, I want the government to ensure that Telangana State High Court is not shifted from old city. I urge the government to take up restoration of heritage building of the Osmania Hospital and construct a new block in 7 acres open land in hospital complex. I request the government to allot 5 acres of land in major gram panchayat and municipalities and new municipal corporation for the graveyards and idgahs of Muslim community. I demand that while announcing the new excise policy from October 1, the excise department should scrap the permit rooms to the liquor sale outlets. I urge the government to issue new food security cards for the all pending eligible application to the earliest. I request the government to take TSRTC as a government department, as the bus service was started in Hyderabad in 1932 under the road transport department as part of Nizam state railways during Nizam rule. I demand that all the vacancies of the city police, Saibirabad and Ratchakunda police commissionerate should be filled up immediately. The post of traffic constable should be increased and fill up and promotions given by those working for 25 years. I urge the government to take up construction of building for the government schools, polytechnics, ITI, junior and degree colleges in the state, particularly in the old city, and fill up the all teaching and non-teaching posts. I request the government to fill up post of faculty in the government colleges and university and appoint the vice chancellor to 12 state university at the earliest. I would like the government to launch coordinated efforts through different departments to control the epidemics of the viral fevers and dengue in the state capital and other places. I urge government to take the issue in the medical and healthcare sector on priority by filling up vacancies of medical and paramedical staff, sanctioning more beds, ensuring adequate supply of the medicines and providing more equipments in the city teaching, maternity and area hospital. I request the government to release Arogya Shri areas of the hospitals and to take steps for expeditious clearance of the CM relief fund applications. I hope that Honorable Chief Minister Sahab will respond to the All India Manjis Ittehad al-Muslimin Shagasans and demands while replying to the demand on behalf of my party, All India Manjis Ittehad al-Muslimin. I fully support the appropriation bill number 2 of 2019. I thank Speaker sir for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you, sir. Mauzam Khan Garu, Sri Aruri Ramesh Garu, Sri Bhatti Vikramarka Garu, Vivekananda Gowda Garu, పాల్గొని తాము చెప్పవలసిన విషయాలు చెప్పారు అధ్యక్ష. వారందరికీ కూడా ధన్యవాదాలు తెలియజేస్తూ, మౌజమ్ ఖాన్ గారు ఎన్ఆర్సీపై క్లారిటీ ఇవ్వాలని అన్నారు. ఎన్ఆర్సీకి తాలూక్సే ఆజ్ తక్ మర్కజ్కే సర్కార్నే కోయి పాలసీ నహీ బనాయా ఔర్ హమే यानी कि हमको रियासती सरकार को आज तक किसी प्रकार का कोई इंस्ट्रक्शन नहीं मिला, कुछ करना या नहीं करना, क्या करना, किसी किस्म का कोई सूचना या आदेश या कोई चीज़ हमको नहीं मिला. इसमें आप मुतमईन रहिए, इतने आसानी से कोई घबराने की ज़रूरत नहीं है, कोई परेशान होने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. हम जो यहाँ है ऐसा कोई आपत्ति नहीं आने देंगे. हमारे रियासत के जो भी सच्चे ईमानदार शहरी हो उनकी पूरी पूरी हिफाजत हम करेंगे, वो जिम्मेदारी हम लेते हैं. आज तक तो मरकज़ के सरकार से किसी किस्म का कोई पॉलिसी या कोई इंस्ट्रक्शन या कोई आर्डर हमको नहीं मिला है. अगर मिले, मिलने पर आपको ज़रूर बता देंगे. सारे पार्टियों से भी बातचीत करेंगे, आपसे भी बातचीत करेंगे, इसमें कोई घबराने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. दूसरा, वक्फ बोर्ड को रिकॉन्स्टिट्यूट करने के लिए आपने कहा, बिल्कुल उस पर गौर करेंगे. जितना जल्दी हो सके उसको रिकॉन्स्टिट्यूट करने का कोशिश करेंगे. और नया सेक्रेटरीट जल्दी बनाने के लिए आपने बोला, आपको सरकार शुक्रिया अदा करता है. शादी मुबारक दरखास्त पेंडिंग है बोले आप, जल्द से जल्द इसको सैंक्शन कर देंगे, इसमें कोई आपत्ति नहीं है क्योंकि गवर्नमेंट स्कीम है. उर्दू, एक उर्दू दा को ऑफिशियल लैंग्वेज में मेंबर बनाने का भी आपने दावा किया है, उस पर भी सोचा जा सकता हो, कोई ना बोलने की बात नहीं है, बिल्कुल हो सकता है. ओल्ड सिटी के लिए मेट्रो रेल का भी आपने जिक्र किया, पहले थोड़ा मुखालफत आई थी, आप लोग जानते हैं, आप लोगों से भी मेरा बातचीत हुआ था लास्ट टर्म में, मैंने खुद आपसे आप लोगों से बात किया था, कुछ प्रॉब्लम्स थे, अब लगता है कि पूरे प्रॉब्लम हट गए, लिहाजा वो काम भी जल्द से जल्द चल पड़ेंगे. ओल्ड सिटी में भी इंशाल्लाह जल्द से जल्द मेट्रो का काम शुरू होगा. 12% रिजर्वेशन तहफ़ात की आपने जो बात किया है, यहाँ हमने ऑलमोस्ट यूनानिमसली पास करके भेज दिया, आप लोग बखूब जानते हैं. मरकज़ के सरकार का जो पॉलिसी है वो लोग पेंडिंग रखे हुए हैं, किसी प्रकार से वो बाहर स्टेटमेंट देते नहीं देंगे, अंदर हमको अभी ऑफिशियली कुछ नहीं कहा, लेकिन फिर एक बार मैं पूरा कोशिश करता हूँ, अगर नहीं होता तो आगे चल के भी फिर एक बार हम लोग यूनानिमसली रेजोल्यूशन पास करेंगे, एक ऑल पार्टी डेलीगेशन चलेंगे. अभी थोड़ा आगे चल के मैं अपने बातों में बताऊँगा. ये एक ही नहीं, कई ऐसे चीज़ पेंडिंग है कैश सेंटर के पास, जो चीज़ें उनके पास नहीं रखना चाहिए था वो रख रहे हैं. जिस प्रकार से कांग्रेस सरकार सेंट्रलाइज कर रही थी उसी प्रकार से बीजेपी सरकार भी कर रहा है, बात गलत है जमहूरियत में, लेकिन इन बातों को मैं आगे चल के बताता हूँ. वो सब मसाइल के साथ इस चीज़ के बारे में भी हम ज़रूर लड़ेंगे, इसको छोड़ेंगे नहीं. मैं अभी तफसील से थोड़ी देर से आपको बता देता हूँ. बाकी कुछ और चीज़ें आपने बताया, बिल्कुल उसके बारे में गौर करेंगे. मेडिकल स्टाफ का रिक्रूटमेंट हुआ है, जितने भी वैकेंसीज है, बहुत ही अहम डिपार्टमेंट है, वो भी जल्द से जल्द भर्ती किया जाएगा, आप इसमें मुतमईन रह सकते हैं.